We were living in a property just behind us in one of these oceanfront condominiums. And, you know, the water breached here at the end of 18th Street and also came in at the roundabout at Tybee. You know, the flooding was pretty extensive down in this area, particularly those in low-lying areas that didn't have elevated homes. I've got a lot of friends that just, you know, took years to recover from it. Battled insurance companies, just, you know, lived in trailers, lived with family. I mean, the disruption is remarkable.
Before we built the dunes, because this is the commercial district, there were at-grade access points where people, Department of Public Works, Marine Rescue, would use vehicles to get on the beach. This is also one of the heaviest traveled, pedestrian-used parts of the beach. And so the dunes you see here were not here prior to 2018. So when Matthew hit us, literally the streets here were flooded. The beach is your first line of defense to protect against storm surge. The dunes are an integral part of that. So when storm surge comes, it erodes the beach. We know that, okay? That dissipates power. Once the beach is gone, it hits the dunes. They will go too. It dissipates power. So our experience is that with dunes as high as we've built them and as long as we've built them, we've diminished the probability that the water actually gets to the property here. If it does get to the property, the expectation is its velocity will have been slowed by the dunes. It's hard to estimate savings per se, but this is our commercial district, so anything we can do is worth it.
So we have been working with the City of Tybee to conduct some research on the new artificial dune that they have created over the last year or so. My lab is a plant ecology lab, and we are doing some work to understand if the vegetation that is being installed in these brand new dunes is doing an equivalent job to what a natural dune is doing. In every case in the bare areas, that sand is eroding away. So if we do not have that vegetation in place, then we don't get those critical functions that a dune should provide. The goal of having these dunes in place is to really help to deal with these issues of sea level rise and to slow the waves and to keep the water out of the City of Tybee and to protect this community.
Well, you know, people live on Tybee and put up with the crowds and the risk because they love the beach and they love the community. And so, you know, anything that can be done to protect the resiliency of the beach and keep it in its most natural state, almost every resident is just wildly for. So I think, you know, individual and governmental programs working together to really do whatever you can to work with nature, not just build concrete, that doesn't work. You need to do what the city's doing, which is really understand the effect of dune management in mitigating the damage so you can recover quickly and live with the reality that, you know, coastal living is not easy.
Our goal, and why we call it resilience, is not to prevent damage from a storm. You cannot do that. If a hurricane hits Tybee, we're underwater directly. Resilience is the ability to absorb the hit of a storm, as I've talked about, the beach, the dunes. You absorb the hit, okay? You recover quickly. So in the case of Matthew, the island was evacuated. We couldn't get in here for 5 days. How do you get that to 3 days or 2 days or 1 day, which is lifting your infrastructure and keeping it over the flood zone? With rising sea levels, our tides are higher. Storm surges are higher and greater. Resilience is the ability to absorb and adapt.